Good morning, dear students. In last lecture, we have completed the prevention of food. How can we prevent our food from microorganisms? How can we prevent our spoilage of food? Okay, we have discussed different methods for prevention of food. In today's class, we will discuss the role of bacteria, microorganisms in nitrogen cycle. In nitrogen cycle, because nitrogen is very important for plants, for soil fertility. So in today's class, we will discuss the nitrogen cycle. This is our nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen cycle means in this cycle, the atmospheric nitrogen convert into the nitrogenous compound. This compound mix into the soil, increase the soil fertility. And again, this nitrogen goes up into the environment, and this cycle continuously running. Okay. So, what is the step of nitrogenous cycle? 78% nitrogen available in the atmosphere. This atmospheric nitrogen fixed by the bacteria, rhizobium bacteria and blue-green algae. Nitrogen is fixed. Then after that, this fixing nitrogen convert into the nitrogenous compound with the help of bacteria. This nitrogenous compound go into the soil and increase the soil fertility. Increase the soil fertility after using these nitrogenous compound used by the plants. And after that, these compounds by the help of bacteria convert into the gaseous nitrogen. And this gaseous nitrogen again mix into the environment. So this cycle continuously running and follow this process. And the another form of fixing of nitrogen by lightning process. By the help of lightning, atmospheric nitrogen fixed in the fixing of nitrogen. Then this nitrogen, fixing nitrogen convert into the nitrogenous compound by the help of bacteria. This compound again go into the soil, and with the help of bacteria, it is converted into the gaseous nitrogen. This gaseous nitrogen mix into the environment. These compounds used by the plants which is eaten by the animals. Now after the death and waste excretion of animals, it mix into the soil and increase the soil fertility. After that, it is decomposed by the bacteria and convert into the gaseous nitrogen. So this is our nitrogen cycle, in which nitrogen first fixed by the microorganisms, then convert into the nitrogenous compound. This compound go into the soil, increase the soil fertility. After, with the help of bacteria, this nitrogenous compound convert into the gaseous nitrogen. This is our nitrogenous cycle. After that, we will discuss the different microorganisms which cause disease. Means these microorganisms which cause disease are called pathogens. And this microorganism which is carried by the different carriers. So in next topic, we will discuss harmful microorganisms which causes disease and its carrier. Yani how this microorganism spread. How these microorganisms will spread. Kaise spread honge? First, disease TB, tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is caused by the bacteria. It caused by the bacteria. And bacteria spread by the, means mode of transmission by the air. Means bacteria spread by the air. And how can we prevent tuberculosis? With the help of, keep the patient in complete isolation, vaccination, which is given in suitable age. So with the help of vaccination and complete isolation, we can prevent the TB. Second disease is measles. Measles caused by the virus, and it is these virus spread by the air. And prevention is vaccination given in suitable age. Second, chickenpox. Chickenpox caused by the virus, and virus spread by the air and contact. The prevention is same, complete isolation and vaccination. Next, polio. Polio caused by the virus, and mode of transmission is air and water, and vaccination and complete isolation is prevention. Now next is cholera. Cholera caused by the bacteria, and this bacteria is spread by the water, with the help of water and food. We should maintain complete hygiene, good sanitation habit, and we use boiled drinking water and properly cooked food. If we follow this condition, then we prevent the cholera. Next, typhoid, caused by the bacteria, and mode of transmission is water, and follow this prevention C. Next, hepatitis B. It is caused by the virus, and virus is spread by the water. So we should drink boiled water and use vaccination. Next is malaria. Malaria caused by the protozoa, and this protozoa spread through the help of mosquito. Mosquito is the mode of transmission of protozoa, and it can be prevented by use mosquito net. We can use spray, insecticides, avoid storage of water. We should avoid the collection of water in a proper place. If in a particular place water is storage, then mosquito develop, and this mosquito spread the protozoa, and protozoa cause the malaria. So these are different disease which caused by the different microorganisms, and this is the mode of transmission, and this is the prevention. How can we prevent the disease? So these are the different type of disease which caused by the pathogens. Pathogens means harmful microorganisms. So in today's class we have completed the use of microorganisms in nitrogen cycle, and in next topic we may have discussed the harmful microorganisms which cause different type of disease, and how these microorganisms spread, means the mode of transmission of these microorganisms, and how can we prevent the following disease. Okay, now thank you so much, and next topic we will discuss in the next class.